Catastrophe is brilliant. You and Sharon.
Oh, thank you.
Not only great on screen together, but the writing is so good. And it's, as a married guy with kids, I've never seen a comedy show. They all tackle the area, but it's in that kind of 8:30, very safe slot. And some of them do it really well.
Yeah.
But this talks about the other murkier, darker stuff that I was really laughing out loud at it because you just nailed it so much.
Well, thank you. Yeah, I mean, I have three boys under the age of 5.
Wow.
And so...
No wonder you're extending your tour.
Yeah.
I'll stay out on the road. I'm extending it by 5 more years.
Yeah, I have to do a bunch of Scandinavian dates in the north, and the roads haven't thawed yet, so we're going by horse and carriage. It's going to be rough going, but I have to do it.
I can be a good dad over Skype.
Yeah, that's fine.
Kids at that age, they don't know the difference between you being in the room and you
image.
On a laptop.
Yeah,
an
totally.
I mean, they're
sitting in a crap-filled nappy, and they're like, can you change it? And I'm like, no, I'm a hologram.
So when you and Sharon were coming up with the show and devising it, how did it work? Did you know what the show was going to be and what you didn't want it to be?
Sure, yeah. I mean, we wanted it to be... brutal, which life is, even a good marriage and a good parenting experience, you know, when you're really in it, I mean, it's just a war zone.
Yeah.
I mean, it's literally bloody. You know, my kid got a bloody nose the other day, my 3-year-old, and I'm holding him because I love him and he's hurt. And then he sneezed with a bloody nose and it looked like I'd been shot in the face. I cleaned him all up and forgot about it. And then I looked in the mirror and I was like, oh God. And just, you know, and not cute little blood. I thought 3-year-olds would have different blood.
Congealed
blood
as well.
Just gutty blood, viscera.
Yeah.
I mean, it was awful. And that's 100% what parenting is. Excuse me, I'm burping inside of my body right now. Should I let it out? Is that better for radio?
No, it's good. I mean, you don't see it a lot on TV chat shows, but it's a shame.
I did.
It's nice on radio. I love that people think it wouldn't be a problem. Can I belch?
Yeah. Sorry, I tried to swallow it.
Yeah.
Anyway.
How do you find touring the UK? Do you find that certain cities, some stuff will go over well? Because there is a difference, isn't there? There's some audiences and some towns and locations have got a different...
You want to hear a funny... This is funny. I don't know. I hope my management isn't like, don't say this.
Your management... are the most laid-back in the world.
Well, here, I should say, the most important thing to say is that I am playing Royal Festival Hall the 12th of May.
It's a beautiful venue.
Very excited about that. So,
you getting the bus to that one?
You never know. I might splurge for an Uber pool. I did Uber pool the other day for the first time, hoping like, oh, please pick up a weirdo, but they didn't. It was just me.
Oh, what a shame.
But anyway, so yeah, May 12th, Royal Festival Hall. But this tour coming out, and most of the shows are sold out, but there's one, Peterborough, they're like, we don't care that you're coming. Peterborough, just nothing. And I checked, and I went to my website, and there was actually a mistake on my website. Every other link went to the venue's ticket thing, but the other one went to like Ocado or whatever for Peterborough, so we just fixed it. But if anyone in Peterborough is listening, please come, because everywhere sold out. Except Peterborough, who either they're like, no, man, you're just not interested, or
maybe
they
don't get Channel 4.
They got on, or they just, or they ordered, they clicked a cotton, or like, oh, I got to get some PG tips, and then they forgot.